Hello, Kara Jacobs here. I'm just going to wait a few minutes to really get started as people are getting on to the webinar. Thank you for joining if you're here. And during the webinar, I'm going to try to answer questions if possible. So I think that's down on the bottom of your screen. And this tiny URL here, which will be on a whole bunch of the slides to come, will take you to my blog where this presentation is. So if you just type that in, it'll bring you right to here. And then the slideshow is right there on my blog, and this slideshow has tons of links, particularly for Spanish teachers. So I'm just waiting a little bit as people are logging on. And thanks to Voces Digital and Teachers Discovery for hosting this and setting this up. Okay, so I'm going to get started going on to the next slide, which is just a little intro slide to just when I go to presentations, I like to see who is the person who's presenting? What is this person? What do they do? What else do they have going on? So my name is Kara Jacobs, and I'm originally from Massachusetts, but now I live in the great state of New Hampshire, live free or die. I am married to an economics teacher and the head of the history department. I have two sons, one of whom is in Spain. This one, he's a freshman. He's in Spain right now with my husband. They're in Cádiz, and they were just at the celebration for Carnaval, which is really exciting, and I was very envious. I've been teaching for 20 years, all of that time in public schools. My husband is a teacher at a private school, so I do live at a private school, but I've been teaching in public schools for 20 years. I used to use Realidades, but now I use comprehensible input. I also use a ton of authentic resources, and I blog at, that's my blog there, and if you click on that, it's a link, comprehensifying and extending authentic resources, where I share tons of resources and ideas with teachers, particularly songs, which is what we're going to talk about today. And I have taught Spanish 1 through AP this year. I have Spanish 2 and 3 now, and I had Spanish 1 Culture and Civ first semester, which is like a level 4, 5, or 6 class. And I am a contributor to the Voces Digital Nuestra Historia and a co-author of the Nuestra Historia Aprender y Preparar, the AP online digital textbook. Oh, and again, if you're just kind of jumping in here, that tiny URL there will take you to my blog where this whole presentation is, and it has tons of links, so it will be useful there. So again, I'm going to get started here. Authentic songs and music videos are an excellent real-world hook for students. Lots of teachers use authentic songs. We use music videos. We have Locura de Marzo or March Madness coming up here for a lot of teachers, so lots of teachers know that, but the big question is, how comprehensible are those authentic songs that we're using? And frequently, not very comprehensible. So in today's webinar, I'm going to talk about going beyond the Cloze and translation activities. So again, this is just a description of the webinar, which if you signed up, you already read this, but I'm just going to read it so you know where we're going. So this webinar will share ideas with all teachers and resources specifically for Spanish teachers about how to create stories out of songs and music videos, and then what to do with those stories after. And I'm going to share 5 different examples. So we're gonna watch the little parts of those videos, and I'm gonna share some things that you could do with them. And then at the end, I have a whole bunch of other videos and links that you could use for a variety of topics or themes. So why would you use stories based on authentic songs and music videos. So lots of teachers use stories. We might use comprehensible readers. You might use stories from Nuestra Historia. For my curriculum, I use a wide variety of things. So my Spanish 3, I'm using some Nuestra Historia, using some of my own things. I use tons of readers. We do silent sustained reading. And then I also use some of those readers as units, but I love using stories that are based on authentic songs and music videos. So I'm just going to walk through about 11 reasons here why. So why you're going to give with stories, you're giving lots of compelling, engaging input, especially if you have the visuals of the song. So when you use a story that's used on a music video, you have images and sounds to go along with this. So you don't just have the text, but you have images and sound, and then automatic engagement. So I'm just going to click on a couple of these videos and imagine your students coming into your class, and most of their classes, they're not seeing things like this, but they come into you and then you're showing them this video and you're really dissecting it. It really can make for some great engagement. So this one, lots of teachers use and love. So I'm just going to watch just maybe 20 seconds of it. It's just so good. So that's a great song, definitely not comprehensible except for the soy yo part, but you can create a story based on that and really delve into that video. Here's another one, another favorite. Excuse me, sorry. So let's just jump ahead here. Porque no bajamos a la playa para así practicar pronto por la mañana y así no hay nadie más cuando bailo contigo. That is another favorite, La Cintura by Álvaro Soler. This one is one of my favorites, and students are always just a little bit like, what is happening? But it's very engaging. So let's take a look at this one.
Brace yourselves.
Jump to my favorite part. Great. I love that video. So that video, you can make a story out of that. And really, she's a travel agent, but she's never traveled anywhere. So it's a great story for the travel unit and such an engaging song with a really good message. And then we have this. It's just another one. So just imagining students having stories based on these music videos. So really delving into the images that you're seeing. Students love that one, and it's very catchy. Okay, reason number 3. So authentic resources, songs, music videos, we're using that as the base of the story. We get cultural diversity and linguistic diversity. So you can choose songs from all over the Spanish-speaking world or French-speaking world or whatever language you teach. And then you can also get linguistic diversity as well, which we're really, as a non-native Spanish speaker, I really want that in my classroom. And as a teacher in rural New Hampshire, I really want that cultural diversity in my classroom. And then we think about the actual standards, communities. I love, this is my favorite standard, probably lifelong learners. So learners set goals and reflect on their progress in using languages for enjoyment, enrichment, and advancement. So if we're using songs, we are hitting that standard easily. And then, you know, if they're thinking about setting goals about understanding the song and then thinking like, how much did you know at the beginning? How much do you know now? I just love that. I love that standard. That's part of what we do. Okay, then we also have the culture standard. So products, practices, and perspectives, focusing on that. a song and a music video that is a cultural product. Within the music video, you see more cultural products and practices. The lyrics can also describe practices, and then you can pull out perspectives. So they're so rich. So we're hitting that standard as well. And then, so if you write the story for a lower level, you're just pulling them up, just plus one about giving them some new vocabulary. But if you also write a simple story, some of them I'm going to share today, it can be really easy input for higher levels, and then you can delve into the song a bit more. And then we have the actual core practices, facilitating target language comprehensibility and guiding learners through interpreting authentic resources. So the stories where you're giving that, facilitating the target language comprehensibility, so writing a story that's comprehensible, and then guiding them through interpreting an authentic resource, which would be the song or the music video. And then numbers 8 through 10, you're going to reach more students if you use stories that are based on music videos. You're going to build class culture. You're going to add joy and enjoyment to your students' day in school. So if we think about, you know, if you ask students, how was your day? If you maybe have a high schooler in your house, how's your day? Boring, fine, the same. But at least in our classes, we have the ability to use music, pop culture, and videos in our class, which can really hook some students that otherwise might not be that interested. And then the last one, they will acquire tons of language throughout the course if you use certain stories based on music videos. Okay, so how to create stories out of songs and music videos, and then what to do with those stories afterwards. So this is my process. There are lots of processes here, but I'm just going to share mine. So I usually find a song, and lots of find songs, obviously, music videos, but people frequently ask me, how do you find all these songs? So I go to YouTube a lot, and then I have recommended. And then if you just keep refreshing recommended, you'll get even more. So just before the webinar, I was refreshing and I came across with this song, which seems so interesting. The woman is talking about, she's from Spain, talking about discrimination that she has seen and experienced because of her velo, because of the veil that she's wearing. So I'm excited to delve into that one. But then I also have two Spotify, and again, this probably exists for other languages, two Spotify lists that I frequently listen to or check out, Latin Pop Rising or Radar Latino. So you can listen to, you know, 20 seconds of a song and say, oh, no, thank you, that's not appropriate. So let's see. And then I listen to it, watch the video, figure out if it's appropriate frequently. No, for a variety of reasons, including lots of objectifying of women, which I am trying to get out of my classroom. And then I listen to the song a lot. I'm a runner, so I run a lot, and I put the song on repeat, listen to it, develop a story with a certain level in mind, and then I take screenshots and usually create a presentation, which I'm going to share here. I'll pull out keywords, make a Quizlet for Quizlet Live, and sometimes I'll make questions, personalized questions for personalized questions and answers that we might do. Sometimes I'll do a whole lot more, or sometimes just a little bit. And then I'll make a Cloze activity and translate the song for students, usually partial. And I still do that, even though this webinar is called Beyond the Cloze. I definitely do the Cloze activity, give them the translation so that they really know what the song is, and I want them to listen to the song. So with this, the stories based on songs and music videos, the lyrics of the song are not the focus. They might be included in the story, but they're not the focus. A variety of input activities over a week or more that will help students acquire the language is also the focus here. So we're going to look at some examples. I have 5 examples. We'll see if I can make it through all of them. But I have examples of songs and then examples of activities you could do that's going beyond the Cloze. But I always do a Cloze activity and a translation. So these are the 5 songs we're going to take a look at. So the first one is for level 1. I used it the 3rd week in my level 1. I have block scheduling, so I have 85 minutes per day. And you could also just use it as a story or a song of a week, of the week. So let's just watch one little part of it. And again, if you're just jumping in here, this tiny URL, which I'll share more, will take you to this presentation, and you can find all the links and the resources here. This is a free resource on my blog. So let's just take a look at this little video here. The song is called Yo No Sé, which means I don't know.
Y me voy enamorando, y como loco pensando, en esos ojos bonitos que solo tú tienes, mamá. Y es que yo quiero cuidarlos, y nunca verlos llorando, a esos ojitos bonitos que cierra conmigo, mamá.
Okay, so, some of it pretty comprehensible, and it repeats yo no sé a lot. So here are the lyrics here. And again, I'm not focusing on the lyrics in this story. I'm getting some, like me voy enamorando is in there. Ojos bonitos is in there. And one of the really cool things, I showed this at the beginning of Spanish 1, and then we brought it back later, and they could understand so much more, which was so wonderful for them. So here is some scenes from the video. So basically, he is in love with this woman, or this woman, he's 20 years old. Through the video, he shows pictures of them. So I just made up in the story, they're friends from childhood. And then at the end, he writes, would you go out with me? Hashtag, or yeah, would you go out with me? But then, oh no, loses the connection because he's doing an Instagram live video with her. Let's see. So this is the story. And I'm not going to read all the stories for the other ones that I share, but just so you can see what you could do with a level one. And I'll translate it into English for those who might not be Spanish teachers. So there's a man. The man is named Mati. He's from Chile. He's 20. And this is actually real information about the singer. I looked it up. He likes nature and sports. He likes a girl. The girl's name is Ana. They're friends. Since always, they're friends since childhood. They talk a lot. He likes her eyes. So that's right from the song. Let's see. He wants a relationship with her. He wants to be the boyfriend of her. He is in love with her. So really simple sentences. But Ana doesn't know that Mati wants more. He makes a decision. He invites five friends to his house, but not Ana. He calls her on FaceTime. My students told me it was actually Instagram, not FaceTime. He sings her a song, and he sings and plays the guitar. His friends play other instruments. And the song is called I Don't Know. In this song, he sings I Don't Know a lot. He sings I'm Falling in Love. At the end, he has this hashtag, but oh no, the connection is lost. And he thinks, I know. And then the question of the students is, what is going to happen? So that's the story that we're working with. So the first day, introducing this to them, I'm gonna play it as they're coming in, maybe the week before, so then they think they know the song. And then we're gonna do listen and draw. So you could do this, they could see the text, or you could have them not see the text. But I would tell for these guys, when I did this early this year, I told them the story and they had to draw it. So they're listening, they're imagining a story. They're not seeing the video yet. And then we would watch the video. So let me just, they guess what happens at the end. So let me just show you what happens at the end. La industria Inc. Oh, yay, she shows up. What a surprise. Students, they love this song. They loved it and they liked the little story too. And then what you could do is Textivate. And again, this is linked here. So Textivate to review that text. And then every day I would have them try to sing the song. So we try to sing, it's a really good brain break. I start with 5 minutes of reading at the beginning of every class, but then we might sing, or even, maybe not the whole song, but just parts of it or the chorus. And then Textivate to have them review the text. Elena Lopez made this. She's a wonderful teacher. She blogs at Aprendemos Juntos, so she shares resources there. Excellent. So a Kahoot jumble with the story. If you haven't seen Kahoot jumble, it asks a question, and then students have to move the boxes to put the sentence in order. So el hombre se llama Mati Gomez. And then, so since when are they friends, they have to put son amigos de las niñas. It's a great way to get them to review text, and it's Kahoot jumble. You could also do TeachVid to review. I love TeachVid. It's pretty amazing to review the song lyrics and a listening activity. So I'm going to show you a little video how this works, but there's English over here, and then they're choosing which lyric they're hearing. So let me just show you this.
Yo no sé. Donde salió tanta belleza, donde se fue toda esa tristeza, yo no sé. Y es que todo va bien, preguntas sin respuestas. Yo no hay fantasmas en mi puerta.
So that is that's really going beyond the clothes. There's a lot going on there. And then you could just do a really basic evaluation. Just fill in the blanks, right? This is Spanish one at the beginning. I'm focusing on those, high frequency words. You could also do true and false or ID specific words. Another evaluation, which I love, this is so fun. I had them created a video, which I'll show in the next slide. They had to watch the video, jot down some notes in English, Spanish, or Spanglish about what they read or see. Then they had to watch it and answer questions in English. So these are the questions they had to answer in English. And I have them answer in English because it's interpretive. I just want to know that they understand. So there were two questions here that they had to infer the meaning. So number two is, what time do you think it is? Give the Spanish sentence that helps you realize what time of day it is. And then also, does this text exchange happen before or after the story that I told you about Mati and Anna? And how do you know that? So let me just show you this little video. And you could do this for any story. It's just a minute 34 long, so I'm going to play the whole thing here. You can see using the emojis really helps. And it's really what students do. Okay, so pretty simple and basic, but they're reading that. It's a little bit more engaging than a reading activity, reading a dialogue. And then this is the, someone suggested I add a little rubric, so I just made this really basic rubric. So exemplary is they answer all the questions correctly and they're able to infer meaning. Just looking at a question here, which activity is the student's favorite? All of them look great. I think one of their favorites is the marker game, which I'm going to get to, Mayela, a little bit later. But be curious to see what other people's favorite activities are as well. Okay. So now getting another unit here. This is by Lola Pena. It's based on this wonderful video that I just love, and really pre-AP, lots of focus on culture in this unit. So let me just show you a little bit of this video. It's set in La Perla in Puerto Rico. It's about a boy. He needs some new shoes. He's working. He gets paid, and then on his way to go buy his shoes, he encounters many people, and he dances away their sorrow. So let me show you what he does. So he sees these two people who are yelling at each other, and then he dances away their pain. I just love this. Just watch. And one of the things I love is telling the students the story, spending a couple days on it or longer, and then finally showing them the video. And when I showed them this video, it was just so wonderful to watch my students watch this video because it's so weird. And the kid, just the way he dances, it's just such a wonderful, wonderful video. So one thing you could do with the screenshots, right? There's a lot of culture in these screenshots. That's La Perla in Puerto Rico, outside of the wall, outside of Old San Juan. And I have a resource to learn a little bit more about that. You can make you could co-create with your students a parallel story using the screenshot. So with these questions, we made up a story. So I tell them, you're not trying to guess the story because you're going to get it wrong. We're just going to make up a story. So we saw screenshots, and again, it's authentic resources from Puerto Rico. The singer is from Spain, but the music video is set in Puerto Rico. So we did that, and then I gave them the story. We walked through the story, got the lyrics, translated it. We're singing it a lot. And then they did an ed puzzle. So with this ed puzzle, they're watching the video, and then they're, and again, for people who are just jumping in here, I'll share the link for this presentation later, but when you click on the picture here, it'll take you to the ed puzzle so you could actually see what it is. But it's the music video and then with questions about the story. So they're getting more input. A lot of them are multiple choice questions, and then they're watching and listening to the video again. Really engaging way to get them to be interacting with an authentic resource. And then another thing you could do with those wonderful screenshots, and again, I think there's maybe 30 screenshots for this one. You can have them listen to statements and match the picture, or read statements and match the picture. I have them do read statements together with their partner and then match the picture. It's a really good input activity. And then they're looking again at authentic images from the target culture. Another thing, and I got this from Christy Placido, a song sequencing activity with a secret message. So this was a great way to interact with the song lyrics again. Just put them, I cut them up in strips. They had to listen to the song and then put it in order. So that's a great activity. Well, this, I really like this. So the story based on the music video, we had that story played bingo. So I gave the students this. Well, let me just answer a question. Sally, I used this at the beginning of Spanish 3. So this was the first unit. I just got my students. I'm on February vacation now in New Hampshire, February break. But I got them 3 weeks ago. I had them for 3 weeks, but we had three snow days, a day off because of the primary day. And then I was out for NECTFL. So we did this unit in about 10 days and in level 3 to start. The story's in past tense, but the co-created story, the questions there, is in the present tense. So we're going back and forth between present tense narration and past tense. Okay, so you can see, part of the story is from these sentences. So for bingo, let me just back up a little bit. So for bingo, they get this sheet and they have to fill in their bingo board. So they have seven choices. They have to write down the five of these. And then for bingo, I say a question and they have to check off or mark off the sentence that answers that. So that was really good because they're writing down the sentences and then they're hearing questions and rereading those sentences. So it's a great activity. And then another classic one for stories, especially if they're based on music videos and they have all these characters, which not only when we have a text without images, we don't have we have an image in our head. But when you use music videos, they have an image of all of these people, the characters from the story. So this is a great one. Who would say it? Who would do it? And then you're sneaking in the conditional tense, which is super easy. And you're giving them diría, diría, diría. And then they have to say who would say it. So that could be used in an assessment or as a partner activity or an alone activity. Then getting into the cultural products, practices, and perspectives, they had two ed puzzles. So really delving into that video where it's set, La Perla. It's a great, it's from 2014, but still really good. And then some of the food from Puerto Rico. So we have the music video as the base, and then we just go out from there, but keep coming back to that music video. Running dictation. So there's three different options you could do, but I gave them this option in the hallway. It was in the first person past tense. They had to go out, they were mixed up, they had to put them in order. And then if you've never done running dictation, if you just Google, or not Google, if you go to YouTube, type in running dictation, you could see videos of it, but I highly recommend it. It involves reading, speaking, listening, and writing, all four skills, and they work, students work together. Highly, highly recommend it. Oh, Damaris just asked, how do I incorporate dancing in learning? We do dance, and I have a couple of videos at the end here that I will get to, because that's another, we did a gesture chorus for this song, which is really fun. Or actually, no, we did it for Sigo Buscándote, which I'll share. Another assessments that you could do, so you have the stories. So this is what they did, conversación simulada. So this is very pre-AP. Students are Danielle, the main character, and then I'm Danielle's mom, and they had to do this simulated conversation. So they had to tell me about their day. So this running dictation that they did was giving them that I form. What else do we do? A cultural comparison. As I just said, the conversación simulada, a spoken retell, and then an original story with some of the same structures from the story. And then, let's see, so we're going to move on. Excuse me, my cat is clawing at my window, so I just have to get my son to let the cat in. Excuse me.
Daniel, can you let the cat in because he's going crazy for the screen?
Okay, I'm sorry about that. Okay, the next story, and it has an important grammatical structure, a catchy tune, and a weird video that students will really want to talk about. Okay, I have another question here. Just a moment, do you have any examples for poetry with music? I teach AP Lit. Oh, I have one coming up, which is wonderful. And Megan, I'm gonna wait to explain that running dictation at the end, so it might take a little bit of time. Okay, so let's get into this next one here. So this song is called Sigo Buscándote, and I found this on either my Radar Latino Spotify list or my other Spotify list. When I first heard it, I thought, oh, this is so great. It repeats a lot and very comprehensible. So let's just listen to a little bit of it.
Dime qué vamos a hacer tú y yo. Llevo preguntándome hace rato cómo es que suena tu voz. ¿Será que somos dos? ¿Te está pasando a ti? ¿Será que llevo rato pensando en mí? Y cuando tú te quieres dormir.
Oops, sorry, Miss Skip, sorry. Missed the best part here.
Dime qué vamos vos. ¿Será que somos dos? ¿Te está pasando a ti? ¿Será que llevo rato pensando en mí? Y cuando tú te quieres dormir, tu cuerpo se acelera por mí. ¿Dónde estás? Yo sigo buscándote. Nunca te olvidaré. Yo sigo buscando, sigo buscándote. ¿Por dónde voy? Quiero escuchar tu voz, me quiero morir de amor. Yo sigo buscando, sigo buscando.
So great. So my son, who's in ninth grade, is my consultant. And he heard the song and he's like, oh, mom, I can understand a lot of that. He's in Spanish too. So I knew this would be a hit. And then it looks like they're drinking. But in the story, I wrote that it's a juice bar and they're all drinking tropical juice. And then we had agua de guanabana the other day. And again, this link is in the slideshow. So you can, these resources for this are all free for this song. So here's the chorus, very comprehensible, repeats a ton, and students really like the song. It was an instant hit. We did this right before break. So that Thursday night, they did an ed puzzle for homework, and then we spent a lot of time in class on Friday, the day before vacation, with this song. So this is something a little bit different. I haven't done it yet because of time and snow days. But I created a survey to do before the story, which really focuses on that structure, that sigo plus ando or iendo, which is a great structure for them to have. So I created a little survey and I actually put it in Voces Digital has a way you can create surveys so you can have students create it and then see the pie chart, which so I'm excited about this. So you can see some of the questions. What do you do when homework is difficult? I keep trying. I don't keep doing it. So I really tried to get the structure in this survey. And then the survey, I'll show you one more question. And again, this is all linked in here, so you can check it out later if you're interested. But I like this question. What do you do when something is mentally difficult? For example, listening the whole time in Spanish class. So I keep paying attention. I keep trying. I keep paying attention, but sometimes I drift off. I keep paying attention, but a lot I drift off. And then, so the answer to the question, this is a BV, Bill Van Patten task. So they'll read it themselves, answer for themselves, interview a classmate, and then they write what they got, either A, B, or C. And then it's almost like a magazine quiz. So they add up their score, and then they see what their level of perseverance is. And then we do a write and discuss. So I'm looking forward to doing that. And it fits with the song, right? Sigo buscándote. And then for this one, I created this slideshow. So I wrote up the story with the images. And students, before we saw the video, they saw the images and the story, just like I said before. So I said it, Maui Riki are from, and Mirna, I use this for levels 2 and 3. But you could simplify it for level 1 and then share back and we could share it out. So let's see. I said it in Venezuela because Maui and Ricky are from Venezuela. So I wanted to highlight some of the, that's spelled incorrectly. Some of the beauty of Venezuela. So I just looked up a national park and found this national park and I just said it there. A lot of the things we hear about Venezuela are not that good. So I thought this would be a good way to highlight that. And in the story, she writes tourist guides. I just kind of made that up. And then in the story, the waiter, we haven't seen a picture of him. He, who is Ovi on the drums, he starts to put notes underneath her drinks. And these are all the notes. And the notes are actually lyrics from the song. So this story has lyrics from the song, which is wonderful if you can incorporate lyrics from the song into the story so that with students they're seeing this, they're thinking about what it means, and then when they hear it they already know it and they feel really good. Okay. They did an ed puzzle. So I love Screencastify. You can take a slideshow, you can record your voice. Let me just show you what this looks like with the, so let's just jump up. So this is going to be my voice. Oops, let's see.
Ella investiga y visita los lugares, places turísticos. Y después, con toda esa información, ella escribe libros sobre los lugares turísticos.
Okay, and then, I should say Maria, why is she in this place? For work. So that is a great way to give them input. All right, so, and again, that is all linked on the blog and in this presentation. Another one, you have two more. Let's see if I can zip through it and then save some time for questions too. So this, I forget, the questions kind of disappear from me over here, but whoever said that they teach AP, this song, and actually this whole unit is wonderful for AP. So this song that I'm about to share, it's called La Canción Es Protesta, is the story of a current event. So this would definitely be used for upper levels. So the central question was, how can music be a form of protesting and education? So let me just play a little bit of the song. I love this song. It's from Chile.
Nunca sé cómo se parte una canción, pero sé que despertó la gente. Se cargó más de la cuenta esta cuestión. La traición viene del presidente. Un estudiante, el torniquete,
Oh, okay. Sorry. So this is the chorus of the song. So it's a beautiful song, nice and slow, really pretty. And this is the chorus. So I don't sing just to sing. The song is protest. If we sing many more, this song will answer you. And then the song, these are the lyrics from the song. And I love that at the end of this unit, because we really delved into Chile, but our two main resources were this song and then the song by Ana Tiju, Cacerolazo, which is, I'll show in just a minute. I love that one too. It's got a totally different vibe. But this one describes what started the massive protests in Chile that started in October with an increase in the metro price, and then students started protesting that. So it mentions like a student, a turnstile, they closed the metro, the olla, which is the pot. So it's explaining what happened to start these massive protests, which are such a model for democracy, because now in April, the Chilean people will vote whether or not they want to write a new constitution. And it sounds like they're going to vote for that overwhelmingly. And then they're also going to vote to decide, is it legislators and citizens who are going to write it or just citizens? So this is something you're really delving into. Lots of cultural practices and perspectives. People, Violeta Parra and Victor Jara, which they had already learned about because we learned about Pinochet. And the constitution is from Pinochet, the dictator there. So they really want that changed. And thank you, Luis and Francois, two Chileans who on Twitter I'm connected with and helped me have some notes here about this song, because some of it was a little bit tricky for me to understand. So one thing you could do this with any song lyrics, but this one who asked about poetry, if you think about comprehensifying this, so putting it in easier language. So nunca sé cómo se parte una canción, like how a song takes off, would match with K. It's a mystery how a song starts. This one right here, a million people protesting and they're hitting the pan really hard. That would be the cacerolazo, is a popular form among many of the protesters. So this is a great one that could be used. I wanna do more of this. Take some time to comprehensify it, but a great way for students to delve in. Then I love this too. Which of these beliefs could be cultural perspectives of the singer? So it's really hard for them to look to pull out perspectives, possible cultural perspectives, because they're beliefs and opinions. So they have to check it off and then underneath write the line of the song that shows why they chose that. Going even deeper, coming back to themselves, think about that cultural comparison. Do you have some of the same perspectives? What are they? Or do people in our country have some of the same perspectives? So for instance, the police or Los Pacos protect the people. So no, that is not a perspective of the singers of this song. They're saying that they're really violent. So maybe my students in rural New Hampshire, no, the police are here to protect us, but maybe people in other parts of our country are thinking, no, the police are not there to protect us. So really delving into some of those cultural perspectives. Okay. And again, if you're interested in this whole unit, it's a wonderful, wonderful unit. And we also did this song, which I'll just show you a little bit of, and on my blog, there's resources for this as well.
Quema despierta, renuncia Piñera, pula la meda, nuestra la moneda, cuchara de palo frente a tu balazo y el toque de queda, cacerolazo no son 30 pesos, son 30.
So, this song is a little bit different than Sigo Buscándote, right? Those images, though, they are authentic images from what was happening in October in Chile. And my students learned about that. And, you know, we talk about protests and democracy. And it was really powerful for them to be able to watch that and understand what was happening. Okay, then we have another. So we're going from a little bit heavy, now something a little bit light. So this video, or another option you could do for a music video, is create a story that happens before the video. So that's what I did with this song, El Mismo Sol, which lots of teachers use, super popular, students love it. Anything by Álvaro Soler is a hit. So I'm going to kind of zip through this rather quickly so I can get to the end there. So let me just show you a little bit of this video. At the beginning, it is silent. I always turn up the volume, but it's silent. So the story that we're going to see is what happened before he gets on his motorcycle. He loves his motorcycle, and he goes and he travels all over the country. So the story is about what happens before, and then basically what he sees when he's traveling around. And then at the end of the story, he decides to write a song, El Mismo Sol. So he is riding around on his motorcycle. There's mountains. He's meeting different people. They're sharing things with him. Okay. Lots of Spanish teachers know that song. And even though it's old now, or it's a few years old, maybe 5 years old, I still think, I know students still like that song. They love it. So introduce the singer and the band, and I would always do this in simple language, just, you know, you get that geography in there, where they're from, how old are they, that simple basic vocabulary, sometimes they forget. Maybe introduce some important vocab with the quick game of Gimkit. So these would be the structures for this story, and you can see we're getting in. I use this at the end of level one. So they're getting some conjugation here, some pretty basic words and good structures. So you could do that. And then do a listen and draw, which I already talked about. Tell the story and have the students draw it. So the story repeats this a lot. On social media, the man sees that, blah, blah, blah. And he says, we all live under the same sun. Why can't we? Blah, blah, blah. So they're getting lots of repetition of that. And then they're also getting repetition of se da cuenta. He realizes. So on social media, he says there are lots of wars and there's the world isn't united. People aren't generous. But then he goes on his motorcycle trip and he sees that they are. And he realizes all these things. And so here are some of my students' drawings from a few years ago. We would watch the video after the story. Sometimes they just have a good video. I just want to show it to them, but it's better if you wait. Do a Cloze activity, translate. Again, Textivate is a wonderful, wonderful resource. If you use stories, I highly recommend it. You have them do it for homework throughout the week. We have a task block, like a guided study in the middle of our day. So that's a great time to do that too. Match the sentences from the story to their own drawings, which is kind of fun, especially if they have kind of wacky drawings here. So they're rereading it and then matching it. So the first day they did this, they just heard the story. And then try to sing. Here's a little video of my Spanish ones singing. I miss those guys. So at the end, some kids are looking down here, but a lot of kids are looking up at the lyric video. And I tell them that to take peer pressure off, because if you say everybody has to sing, they're like, no, I'm not doing that. But if you tell them it's part of their grade, it takes peer pressure off and they can say, well, I'm just singing because it's part of my grade. And then the kids who actually do want to sing end up singing. So I love that. And they do, they end up singing. Let's see. Just reading some of the comments there. Ooh, anonymous attendee from Honduras. If you could contact me later, I have some questions for you about Honduras and a story that I wrote. I need a little feedback. It'd be wonderful to get some feedback from someone from Honduras. Okay, student lens, another thing you could do is problem and solution. That was a really good one. And I'm just speeding through this because I'm nearing the end here. Sing again, always have them sing. The marker game is a wonderful, if you click on this picture, it'll take you to it, but it's a true or false listening activity. I mentioned this is one of my favorite and my students' favorite. You say a true or false statement, two students are sitting together, they have a marker in between them. If it's true, they grab it and they get a point. If it's false and they grab it, they lose too. Students, for some reason, they just love it. And they listen intently, it's wonderful. Again, we sing again. So I'm talking about spending 2 weeks on this song, maybe just 10 to 15 minutes a day. And then, so you could do a little quiz then. or you could do some Quizlet Live, and not just English to Spanish, but fill in the blanks. Looks like this, so they're reading a little bit more. Quizlet Live is great. You could do questions and answers and fill-ins like that. Sing along, maybe have them do a gesture course. This isn't El Mismo Sol, but this is my students doing a gesture course for, I think, La Cintura. That was my little culture and civ class last year. And students, you don't know, well, I guess you have some classes that will dance and some won't, but a lot of my classes will dance and they love it. You could also do freeze frame. So give students strips. They have to act it out and take pictures. They love taking pictures of themselves. Sing again. Kahoot Jumble, which I already mentioned. Sing again. And then favorite lines from the song. You could ask them that. Another thing wonderful, fun to do with a song is I say the English, and then they have a race to say the Spanish lines. That could be a really fun activity, going over the actual lyrics. And then do a dance. So there are tons of Zumba videos, and I meant to put it in here, but I forgot. I presented about this at a conference, and I even had the teachers up and dancing. But let's just take a look at this and imagine your class trying to dance along with it, or and you too. So fun. You get the whole class doing that, and ridiculous, and I'm a terrible dancer. Okay, then an evaluation. This is really basic. This would be over 10 days, 10 to 15 minutes a day, a little quick evaluation, true or false, and then they have to translate the bold words. So that's the last song that I've shared. I'm going to just share a few more, and then I'll take questions. But so what I've done, what I've shared, is a level one mini unit with Yo No Sé, and then I did Bailo La Pena, which is a big unit with lots of pre-AP things and really spending a lot of time on that. Sigo Buscándote, I'm not really using it as a unit, just using it for the song of the week and doing some other activities with it. And then I shared La Canciones Protesta and Cacerolazo, which is part of a really big unit. And then this El Mismo Sol could be the song of the week or weeks over two weeks. Oh, another wonderful thing is to have students make videos. When they do this, is so wonderful. And we don't have time to share them, but maybe I'll just put like 10 seconds. It's my AP class from 3 years ago. So fun. And then last year's AP class, they did La Cintura. Oh, their Spanish is so good. That's not their Spanish. That's from the video. So let me jump up. So fun, especially after the AP test when you still have 6 weeks left. That was perfect for us to do. Okay, let's see. I have a couple questions. I'll answer those in just a second. Let me just run through some other things. I want to answer Victoria's question. So some other level one stories, and these two are free and they're linked on my blog, and I'll share that link again in a minute. This is a wacky ending. This one is a cute little love story. This one's from Chile. This guy is from Panama, Sech, and Nikki Jam's from Boston, Puerto Rico. If you want to get some LGBTQ representation, these two videos and stories are free on my blog, and they're really good. This one has immigration. It has John Legend singing in it. It's really a really, really good song. Perspectives of immigration, Un Besito Más and Ice El Hielo. You can really delve into that. If you want a graduation send-off, this is a wonderful song. All-time favorite, Robarte Un Beso, for intermediates and novices. This is free for novices, really good one. And this one, Ariane Dowd and I created together on Teachers Pay Teachers. You can get that one. Wacky and weird videos, two of my favorites I mentioned earlier. Love those. Flip the script. So taking that, how can I say this? More of a feminist approach to some of these videos. So I wrote up some stories that do that. And I just have a message here. A couple of chats that I'll answer. Sorry. To My Love. Everybody loves that song. Beautiful. Ridiculous food related song. And these two are free. Bendo Pan. Students love it. Wacky weird. These two are secretly tourism videos. This one about Lima, Peru. And this one about Ecuador. So there's tons of culture in those. A couple of stories for intermediates. Those are both free. And these are both free, with lots of pre-AP stuff in this one, of simulated conversation. And other activities, information about the singer, who did it, who said it. I'll let you just look at these later, but this link right here has a link to the slideshow, which as you see has a lot of links. Okay, I'm gonna try to answer a couple of questions here. So Victoria asked about, how did I teach the gestures? Did I create them myself or have the students help create them? I think I do a little bit of both. But it's probably better if they create the gestures, because it's just more meaningful to them. And it, you know, kind of like a one word image, or when you co-create a story, the more engagement you have and the more people who are contributing to what the whole class does, the better. So usually I try to get them to do it. And let's see. Oh, thank you, Sally. And I have a couple other questions here that Erin has texted me. How many class periods or minutes do you typically spend on songs? So it depends. It can vary. I have my class periods are, I meet every day for 85 minutes. Sometimes the song, so Bailo La Pena, was the unit. So we were spending most of the class period on that, with some Estrella del Día interviews interspersed in. But sometimes I might spend 10 to 15 minutes. Depends what else I have going on as a unit in the class. And then Martina asked, do I have instructions for the marker game? I linked them on that slide to Cynthia Hitz. If you Google her, not sure where that slide is, but Cynthia Hitz and marker game, and she has instructions there. And then someone said, do students complain about spending so long on the same song? Sometimes they do. They definitely are like, okay, can we please move on from Bailo La Pena? So it was really good that I could give them another song, Sigo Buscándote, before vacation. So they're like, okay, we're done. But they also know it. And then when I bring the song up later, they really know the song. So yeah, sometimes they do, but they complain about everything really. Students complain about a lot of things. So let's see. There was another question about the running. Let's see. So I'm just looking through the questions. Thank you for the questions and for attending here. And how do I deal with a student who doesn't want to engage? That's a great question. So usually those students who I find who are really, really reluctant, when I realize that, I seat them in the back, so that they're, lots of times being really reluctant is really about confidence. So I put them in the back, and then hopefully maybe try to find out what type of music they like. And there's only so much I can do. Hopefully they'll eventually just get on board. And Jennifer, yeah, 15 minutes a day doing music video, maybe. Again, I think I answered that question a little bit. Depends what, if the music is the focus. So let's see. So what's the advantage of using music? I addressed that a little bit at the beginning. And again, you could go to that little tiny URL and see a lot of it, but it's engagement, really. And using authentic resources and authentic voices from the target culture. So those images are really The images, the sound is just so engaging, and it's authentic, and we're hitting the ACPL standards of communities and cultures easily when we do songs. The running dictation, someone asked about that, so I will explain that quickly. I'll try to explain it quickly. So I'm okay with my students leaving the classroom, so I post, say, 10 sentences out in the hallway. Students are in groups of three or four, and then within the group, one at a time, one person goes out to the hallway, memorizes the sentence, they can go out as many times as they want, comes back in, says it to the group, the other students write it down, and then the next person goes out. And the sentences could be true or false, or put the story in order. So that's usually what I do. So it's reading, listening, writing, and speaking, and it's great for class culture. Okay, trying to look at these. And if you go to my blog and you have song suggestions, please share back. And lots of times I get stories that people share. They use my resources, they create their own stories, and then I have even more stories. So that's wonderful. I share a lot for free. If more people start doing that, think about how many wonderful things we've had. Thank you for those of you who are saying that you've learned a lot. That's good. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. Let's see, and I think we will end that, but you can contact me again on my blog or via email. And my blog is this comprehensifying and extending authentic resources. So thank you so much for attending and listening to me. It's always weird to be sitting in my bedroom. Here's my pillows, talking to a group of people. So thank you.